growth. It's great. It's a fantastic opportunity to see what you can achieve from such a small club and such a small budget, and not having enough money to buy. Like, we just bought a dryer there, which we need to buy, but that took me about 2 or 3 weeks to get the money for that.
Dette historien om en helt spesiell fotballklubb.
This is our technology.
En fotballklubb på 7. nivå I England, som til tross for få midler, har klart det utrolig nok en gang I verdens eldste fotballturnering.
It's great when you hear the third round be mentioned by Blyth Spartans, because it's I think it's every non-league footballer's dream to play as high as you possibly can the FA Cup. The first round's normally the cup final that you want to be in. We're lucky enough to get in the third round, which is quite unbelievable.
Blyth Spartans kan blant annet skilte med en tribune med 563 sitteplasser, to benker à la denne typen, og dusjfasiliteter som dette. FA Cup betyr muligheten til å innkassere store midler fra draktsponsorer.
Charity.
Blyth Spartans velger I stedet å gi pengene tilbake til samfunnet.
We don't get paid a penny for it. So the Community Foundation is a local charity to get people into work, and it's the chairman's charity. So we've got two charities on our kit, you know. Very, very rare.
If Barcelona can do it and support UNICEF, why can't Blyth Spartans do it with the Community Foundation?
Vi I Blyth I Nord-England, en liten havneby med omlag 35 000 innbyggere. En gang var dette senter for kull- og shippingindustri, men nå det lite igjen. Bortsett fra et fotballag.
It's a big thing, a real, real big thing, especially when they have a good cup run. There's days when sort of Blyth's in the news for the wrong reasons, but whenever Blyth's in the reason for the football, it's sort of brings a sort of warm glow to you, really.
You know, build the town up, get it back to the way it was, you know.
It's not just the first time they've been in the FA Cup, it's about two or three times then. They might like score goals and they might win today.
Go on, Blyth! Go on, Blyth!
Det bare to timer igjen til en av de viktigste kampene I historien for Blyth Spartans. Dette mannskapet som kan gå inn I historiebøkene for alltid.
Yeah, I'm excited. I just want to get out on the pitch now. Just been waiting all day. I just want to get on the pitch, sick of waiting now.
I'm excited. I think everyone's going to be up for it, so there'll be no nerves in here. All excited for the game, just see what happens.
Mens Blyth Spartans ligger på 16. plass på nivå 7 I det engelske ligasystemet, har storklubben Birmingham vunnet 5 av sine 7 siste kamper I den nest øverste divisjonen. Men på Crafton Park denne ettermiddagen, det en helt spesiell stemning. Stopper ikke der. For Robert Bale sørger med sine to skåringer for at hvert 0 til pause. Robert Bale, som til vanlig jobber som bartender. Ingenting varer evig. Heller ikke dette. Etter hvilen skårer Birmingham 3 mål. Og cup-eventyret til lille Blyth Spartans over for denne gang.
Disappointing result in the end because we're 2-0 up, but you've got to be proud for how far we've came.
It's just very emotional because I'm a Blyth lad and I know all these lot, but I'm going to see the family and that, so I'll shake hands with everybody.
That's football, you know. We'll be back here next Saturday supporting the lads again. This is real football. This is, you know, your local community. I live down the road. The vice chairman lives across the road from me. I see the manager when I'm walking my dog every day. That's what football's all about to me.